Hey guys, before we get into today's video, I wanted to give a huge shout out and a thank you to our sponsor today, Guitario. As a lot of you have shared, you're having difficulty learning guitar because it's just really unorganized going through the video format on YouTube and trying to figure out what I should learn, what order I should do it in, or even if you're doing it right. Guitario is a service that provides step-by-step guitar lessons. They have a wide range of lesson plans that teaches you blues, rock, rhythm, lead, fingerstyle, reading music, and there's a lot more on there. And an area that a lot of musicians have a huge gap is actually music theory, and they provide music theory lessons on there as well. Definitely go check out their music theory lesson plan series. It gives you little bite sizes of information to absorb and really comprehend. Try a 7-day free trial, no credit card required, at www.guitario.com/becomethenight. Make sure you put that become the night at the back so that they know that I sent you. All right, guys, on with the show. Hey guys, it is Mike with Become the Night. Welcome back to another Song Suggestion Friday. This is the show where you guys put your suggestions in the comment section down below of songs that you would like my feedback and opinion on. I grade those songs in a plus sign, equal sign, minus sign, depending on whether or not I would actively seek out or actively avoid those songs. I take a number of them, I throw them in a poll. Patrons at a certain tier also get to throw their suggestions into that poll. And then the patrons vote on them. I take the top ones, I listen to them. I also do paid critiques as well. If you would like a paid critique, email me at becomethenight@gmail.com. Let's begin. American Life by Primus. There's this weird legato bass riff that pretty much is the meat of our whole song. The vocals are weird as usual, and by that I mean weird delivery. Pretty simple melody. This whole song is very repetitive, and actually one of the least weird songs I've heard from Primus. All of the parts are very straight ahead. The drums aren't recorded the best, but they're not terrible. Production all around is not really ideal, but I think it's kind of how it goes for their sound. I will say that the bass actually sounds great. As weird as some of the guitar leads were, I actually liked them. Total grade for this song, equal sign. Falling Back to Earth by Haken. Love this intro and first verse. The harmonic relationships and the rhythms that are going on in this entire tune are awesome. Just to get this all out of the way in one fell swoop, the production's fantastic. It's kind of a fusion of hard rock and jazz, and the theory that they're kind of really hanging around is just loving dissonance and lack of resolution. The thing that I perceive as the chorus is excellent. The sonic picture is huge and textured and has an awesome melody. At 251, I love the unique timbres at play here and the syncopation. Super dope guitar solos with excellent expression. All of the soundscapes in general are fantastic. All the soundscapes in general are excellent, but especially starting at 555. Oof, so good. It's an excellent ending. It's a fantastic prog venture. If you haven't listened to Haken, you need to go give him a chance. Total grade for this song, plus sign. Officer Down by Bad Wolves. The bass guitar might be a little loud or just mixed that way intentionally. They mixed this song to maximize the crunch of the guitar and boom of the bass so that when they do their chugs, like that type of shit, they're genting, if you will. It really emphasizes those parts to sound really crunchy and really boomy. But then when you stop playing parts like that in the song, you sacrifice a lot of tone and a lot of the spectrum. I'm not sure I was a fan of that choice. Vocals are actually pretty cool. Good growls, solid melodies, good vocal delivery. Not really liking the rhythm guitar tone. It was definitely pushed a little hard in the high mids, like I'd talked about. The beginning of that guitar solo was really cool, and then the rest of the way through it just kind of lost me. Some cool things here for sure, but not really my thing, honestly. Total grade for this song, equal sign. Straight Out the Gate by Tech N9ne featuring Serj Tankian. Love the organ intro. Tech N9ne's flow is insane, great rhythm choices, and super tight. Oddly enough, my least favorite part about this song was Serj Tankian. It's not that his part is bad, it's just that it feels out of place. That's definitely not my favorite melody of his. I couldn't tell if it was the way they mixed him or if it was the microphone that they used, but his voice sounded thinner and more nasally than it normally does, and you could tell that's how they do it when they produce for Tech N9ne. That's not the way you should necessarily mix Serj's voice. Absolutely love the beat of the song. Lots of natural samples and a cool tremolo. I don't know if it's a bass or a guitar line. At 150, the harmonized rapping is dope as fuck. Besides how they mixed Serj's vocals, the mix is excellent. Not much else to it. Killer rap song. Total grade for this song, plus sign. A Looking in View by Alice in Chains. I have not listened to any of their new stuff as of yet. The guitar tone with the bass is huge.
fantastic mix. Really like the verse melody and harmony. The vocal delivery is strange with this style, though. I don't know if I like that or not. The riffs are simple, but they're cool. Really love that drum mix. The way that they end each verse, the way that he sings that, sounds a lot better than what the verses did. Chorus is pretty catchy. It's your usual song structure. The bridge is okay, nothing crazy there. There's a decent amount of dynamic throughout the song, but not that much. Enough for it not to be static. Definitely could have created a better dynamic if we had done more interesting drums. The drums were pretty blasé throughout the song. For a 7-minute song, there's surprisingly very little to talk about. They really just take their time with this pretty formulaic song, almost. Total rate for this song, equal sign. Erised by Periphery. I love just about everything about this song. Pre-chorus melody and the chorus melody are infectious, at least to me. Vocal performance is excellent. Spencer Sotelo's, oh my god. This album has a much brighter mix on it than any of their other albums. Of course, Matt Halpern's gonna be insane. I love his drumming. There's a really cool soundscape that's built by the guitars in the verses and at the quieter parts. First guitar solo is pretty tasty, focused around the melody. Then after that, we have this weird synthy part that actually gives Matt Halpern an opportunity for a drum solo, which is sick. And then, how could I forget John Petrucci taking a guest solo on this song? Absolutely kills it. What the fuck would you expect? I'd be shocked if most of you haven't heard this song already. Total grade for this song, 2+ signs. Maudlin of the Well. That's the name of the band. I'm not saying the name of the song. That'll be on the screen. Super mellow, pseudo-samba type of feel. Love the string octaves that they decide to throw in and out of the song. Just when I thought we were mellow enough, we mellow out even further, and the only thing I could call it is a verse. I do not care for the vocals in the verse at all. I mean, first of all, there's zero room on those vocals and everything else is crazy spacey, so it does not fit room-wise. The delivery is annoying to me on a spiritual level. Like, I want to fucking equalize this song. By the way, that's like the only major complaint I have about this song is the way that he sings. The soundscape that they build is actually really cool. After all of those creepy fucking murder you vocals, then they actually have some nice loud harmonized vocals that sounded great. There's like a cool classical guitar solo at 3:20-ish. Loved it. Sounded fantastic. At 5:30-ish, we start to get a little bit of life and a little more energy into this. And then we go into like some odd-timed pronounced statement. Then we're back to basically another song at this point. I do absolutely love the sound of this part where it kind of releases from the pronounced statement, but it's like, why don't you just make this 2 tracks? As we go into this mellowed out part, there's an awesome contrast between the piano and the guitar. Oh, it sounds beautiful. Then we have a very long, gradual crescendo that follows, and it feels great. Production all around is very solid. Super clear, very thought out. Typically, I don't like drums that sound like that, but for the sound that they're going for, they're actually a perfect choice. It's a tad long-winded for me and what I like, especially considering it's so mellow, but I can definitely understand why people would really like this. Total grade for this song, equal sign. Nottingham Lace by Buckingham. Oh, wow, by Buckingham. Nottingham Lace by Buckethead. Intro riff is really cool. He's got a really interesting guitar and bass tone. I like kind of our main melody before we get to this infinitely looping riff. Production all around is very solid. The drum mix actually kind of reminds me of Red Hot Chili Peppers, just more in your face and less garage. His melodic phrases are very interesting. Definitely not what you expect. The song turned out to be a shit ton more repetitive than I anticipated. His solo kind of weaves in and out of being very melody focused, very chilled out, and kind of more of a feel play, and being shred-tastic tasty. There is lots of feel in his playing, and he's not as feel-oriented as, say, like a Steve Vai or Satriani, but you can definitely notice. About 2/3 of this song is him just shredding over top of the same riff over and over and over again. Killer player, but not really much else here. Go listen to it. Total grade for this song, equal sign. Kingdom by Devin Townsend. Not Devin Townsend Project. Devin Townsend. Great intro, except that's the whole song. Very, very bright mix. Like, honestly, I think too bright. What the fuck is that synth sound in the intro? Kind of sounds like the Doggo sound, like the synth sound from Undertale. Townsend gives us a powerhouse vocal performance, as to be expected. My favorite part of this song is the pre-chorus because it gives us something different other than cranked up to 10 constant double kick and screaming vocals. Don't get me wrong, the way that it starts out and does the first verse and everything I think is great, but then you make that your chorus and you go right back into the first verse, and the verses are very long, so like you just get like what the fuck else do you got, like, please. It almost never comes down from 10 the entire song except that pre-chorus. It is a cool soundscape that he makes. It's just a little much. It starts to plateau in your brain. The guitar tone is cool. I can't distinguish any bass, to be honest with you. I'm sure it's there, it's just quite low in the mix, or it could be how they mastered it. Absolutely too much double kick in this song. Far too much. Vocal melodies are pretty great all around. Everything else just gets boring after a while because it doesn't change. Same guitar part, same drum part. The bass part could be playing something different every measure for all I fucking know. You can't hear it. Definitely not my favorite song of his. Total grade for this song, equal sign. Jesus of Suburbia by Green Day. Starts off with kind of an old rock and roll groove. This is just fucking typical Green Day shit, man. The vocals sound like Green Day. The mix is okay. It's recorded great, but the drum mix seems a little thin, a little too bright. At 153, we go to another classic rock feel. Who would have guessed? Although I do like the original vocal melody they were using over top of this style better. At 345, you have a slight accelerando that goes into a 3-4 feel. Honestly, I don't really care so much for this, but probably feels better live if you would do this live. As I suspected from a Green Day track that is over 9 minutes long, this is their attempt at being prog. And their different style changes would probably be more significant to me if I was actually paying attention to the lyrics, which I'm not. At 5:30, for some reason, they decide to sound like royalty-free musicians. To be honest, I could keep listing off all of the different feels that are going on in this song, and it'd be really boring, just like this song kind of was to me. I mean, is it interesting that they could go to all these different feels? I guess so. It's really not that difficult, and none of the parts actually stuck out to me as like a, okay, this is cool. They were all kind of humdrum. And there's a number of those transitions that definitely feels forced as well. If you like Green Day, you'll probably enjoy this. The instrumentation on everyone's part is so fucking predictable that I can't appreciate the where will they go next vibe that they've been trying to create here. I mean, where will they go next? Somewhere else that's fucking mundane at best. Total grade for this song, equal sign. My first suggestion for you this week is Arrow by Emperor Norton. Full disclosure, these guys did pay for a song critique via email, and I did give it back to them, and I was highly fucking impressed. The guy who sent it off to me said that they sound like old school prog and have lots of old influences, like Yes, Genesis, Rush, Neil Morse. Well, Neil Morse is an old school prog, but he pulls from them too. And actually progressed that sound. And I have to say, dude, I listened to it and I was actually very impressed with their writing. These guys are still a young band, but they could release some fantastic stuff in the future. They're going back into the studio soon. Best of luck to those guys. Go check them out. My next suggestion for you this week is Demolition Blues by the Blind Tigers. Blind Tigers are the band that is co-written by my buddy Mike Rand, who has been on the Snobcast with me. Demolition Blues is just a good old rock song, and he wrote it about Nashville. And remember, this is not a protest song. It's the Demolition Blues. My last suggestion for you this week is Hombre Máquina by Agora. And this is actually a song that one of the people who did a super chat wanted me to listen to and get my opinion on, but I had never listened to the song. So I'd listened to it after the stream was done, and this song kicks ass. There's a lot of time when you have foreign singers singing in their own language to what I would consider more Americanized music. The vocals grate on me, but I actually really enjoyed the vocals on this one. There are a couple parts that got a little too nasally, but that's besides the point. This song kicks ass. Good prog metal. That is it for Song Suggestion Friday. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave your suggestions in the comments below. If you'd like to be a patron, get power to the patrons, go to the link in the description of my Patreon, pledge $5 or $10 or more a month. If you'd like a critique of a song that you have done, you can email me at becomethenight@gmail.com. You can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter at becomethenight. Thank you guys so much for watching. See you in the next video. Rock on!